What's up, traders? Going 8 for 10 today. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Always appreciate that support. Throughout this, if you do have any questions or comments, feel free to leave those down below. There's links to the Discord and the Twitter down below as well. Feel free to join those. And we're going to jump right into this. First trade was on blue. At the end of this, by the way, we're going to go ahead and jump into the TraderSync just to kind of see how we're doing overall. As you can see, previous resistance from Friday, 597, made a decent little move up to 625. We actually started this at 616 a little bit early, went up to that 625 area. That was just in case it continued. Came back down, tested that previous resistance, took some off, hoping that this would be one of those ones that kind of dies all day. But we're going to find out real quick that pretty much none of those did that, and took the rest off as it climbed back up towards our average. So decent little first win on blue. Second trade was on TH. Same thing, previous resistance from Friday, 1450. Get a nice move up through 15. We end up starting this one at, let's see, 1550. High was 1557. Get a nice pullback all the way down to 1507. 1505, actually. We get filled at 1516. And as you can see, this one ended up going back to the highs as well. Decent little trade there. Next trade was on ENVX. We actually took two trades on this one. Previous resistance from pre-market was actually up here at 2084. We were watching that. The highs and support, as you can see, was being used from Friday, 1955, and made a decent little move up into that resistance area. Start this at 59. It actually went up to 75. Give us a nice little pullback right away, all the way down towards 2013. We actually got filled at 2015, pretty much bottom ticking this before it decided to go up higher. Looking again for an extension through the high from pre-market, and we ended up getting a move up to 2126. We get filled at 2119. Nice little pullback. We get filled and it decides to go higher, basically just using our previous resistance as a support line. E was our next trade. PDD, same kind of thing. Previous high all the way down here at 764 on Friday. Nice little, pretty slow move up into the eights. Finally kind of picked up a little bit, got up to 829. We got filled at 824. Decided to try to go a little bit higher. I was really looking for that $8 retest to try to take this off, but it did get a decent little 2 minute pullback here. Started to go higher. Figured just like everything else this morning, this was going to continue higher. But unfortunately, it kind of faked us out. It took this off basically break even as it was going up. Would have stopped us out at break even had we let it, and would have been a fake out. Tried to go back higher. It was just putting in a lower high and then gave us that $8 test. So a little bit sad on this one, but I kind of was biased that I was going to take this off because everything was just reclaiming high of day at this point. And that is why I took this one off. Next one was PDD. Check this one out. Previous high was from this morning's intraday, 47.56. Nice move up through there, up through 48. Again, kind of slow, but then we get a nice little volume candle and we get a high here, 49.25. We got filled at 49.20. It decided to try to go a little bit higher here, 49.43. Ultimately ended up failing. And as you can see, this one decided to die off. It did try to go a little higher right when we got out, but it did ultimately fizzle out. Next trade was on RRC. So we actually ended up taking three trades on this one, which it's going to look kind of silly. And I'm going to tell you my thought process on this. So previous high from, I was using this one, all this stuff in pre-market. I'm not really sure what was going on there, but pretty distinctive line here at 34.33. Nice move on volume, pretty much volume out of nowhere almost on this one. Starts to fizzle out. And so my thought process is I wasn't in this because it started to go pretty slow. I was basically letting this put in a top and I was going to try the backside. So usually in the past, when I would try backside moves, I would look to get in on the break of that high candle, which is 35.20. You can see we got in at the, actually it broke down through, and when we hit the button, it actually popped back up and gave us a good fill. But when I got filled, I was essentially telling myself, just like in the old days, when you try backside, you use high of day as a stop. But if I would have started it on this candle here, at say the same entry, 35, we'll just say 35.18, close enough. And it decided to go higher. We didn't quite get an ad because we would have been looking through 35.50 for an ad. And it decides to try to pull back, but doesn't, and then decides to go higher, I'd still be in it. So I started with a worse average, but I'm letting it continue because there was no real pullback, right? There was no like continuous red bars to the downside. But this is obviously in hindsight. I decided to cut it at high of day because that's just what I did when I used to try backside. Well, I realized it looked like it was going to be a fake out because we didn't get very high. through that previous high, and it started to come back down. So I started it again. It did start to come back down. It started to kind of weasel its way back up there. And I basically said, okay, well, I'm just going to use high of day again, because that's what I do when I'm trying to catch the backside. So I actually add to this. And of course, I'm pretty good at this. Usually like right after I get an add, it decides that's when it's going to go. I sat there for like 2 minutes contemplating, do I want to add if this wants to continue lower? And then finally, I'm like, you know what? I'm just going to add. So I do. And then right after that, it sparks right up to high of day. And we take it off again. As you can see, the green arrow kind of behind that one. Well, it goes up through and kind of fakes out again. This time I'm like, you know what? I'm just going to wait until it comes down and actually breaks this key level, which it starts to. And I end up jumping back in with the same size that I had here after I added. And we tried to scale out of this. Ultimately, I was looking for much further down on this last little piece, but we ended up almost getting back to break even on this one. We took two smaller losses, but then one decent sized win to almost get back to break even on it. Had we taken it all here, we would have been a little bit above break even on the green side, but I decided to see if we could actually make some money off of it by letting it continue down at least to that like 3450 area. And we just didn't get it, decided to curl back up. And as you can see, it decided to die after that. And then ultimately it's making its way back up. So a little bit frustrating of a trade, a few trades there on RRC, because had I just not cut this one and then got one add up through 3550, which would have been up here, our average would have been around that like 3540, 35, you know, high 3530s. And then ultimately we get the breakdown and we're nice and green on it. So a little frustrated, but it's something we learned. We learned from it, right? That's the whole point of this, is to always keep learning. So anyways, after RRC, we had one more trade, which was on CABA, C-A-B-A. And this one was pretty standard. I was really hoping for up through two on this one, 177, started to make its way up, made a decent little move. Couldn't get through two. And so we ended up starting this at 198. The high at that time, I think, was two exactly. Yep. And came back down, gave us a fill, a decent little trade there on CABA. And as you notice today, everything was just starters. If we scroll through the list and take a look, you can see just starter, just a starter, just a starter, just the two starters. There are two separate trades, just a starter, and then the crap on RRC. So pretty crazy. We still made a decent amount considering we only got starters. But, you know, with starting smaller, unfortunately, when you only get your starter, you know, you're only going to make starter size wins. So I'm not upset with it, but at the same time, it is what it is. As you can tell, my starters were a little bit bigger. Last couple of weeks, they were what, like $7, $8. And now they're starting to be, you know, around the $10 range. So I'm going to keep scaling it. And I did that just because I wanted to do it anyways. I'm still at the end of the month, as long as everything's going good, going to double everything and go that route. So TraderSync real quick. I don't know if I have this disabled. Yeah, I do. Okay. Just real quick, can kind of give you guys an update on where we're at. We are now, I believe, $100 or so over where we were over here. If I can get it to go. There we go. That is not the right number. It's showing me a wrong number. I don't know why. It's kind of odd. Before it was showing it to me there. Is it 893? I feel like that's not right. But anyways, we're back over 5,000. On the year, or this is the last 2 years. Sorry, this is taking forever to load for some reason. Oh, you know what? I know I was taking forever to load because this is actually our entire trading career, because I can see the chart over here. Because I was showing some others. Oh, wait, is it? Yeah, because there's nothing here. So if we do year to date, which is what I wanted to show you. There we go. So we're up almost 2,000 on the year. Profit factor 1.4. Win percentage still around that 80 to 85%. It seems to be kind of what I do. And we're doing pretty good. I really like what it looks like, especially these last few weeks. We're just kind of chucking along, which was right around here. We took that decent size loss on, I don't even remember the ticker. Was it ACAM? And we've been trucking along ever since. Really wish we could go back and retrade ACAM for real. Would have been nice to see if that all worked out. But, unfortunately, we can't do that. So That's all I got. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Always appreciate the support. If you do have any questions or comments, like I said in the beginning, feel free to leave those down below or find me in Discord or on Twitter. And I'll see you guys tomorrow. Peace.